Hey guys, what is up? Summit here, and I'm back for another video. So guys, today in this video, I'm going to basically be talking to you about one of the most famous formulas or equations in physics. That is, E equals mc squared. So, I'm going to basically be talking to you about what this means and how you can use this in calculations and how you can use this in like some sums and formulas. So, let's get started. So guys, first things first, what does E equal mc squared mean? What is the full form of E equals mc squared? So the full form of E equals mc squared is energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. Okay, so now what does this mean, now that we know the full form? What this basically means is that that mass can be converted into energy, and energy into mass. So how do you do this? So to convert mass into energy, so to find the amount of energy in a certain amount of mass, what you have to do is you have to take that mass and you have to multiply it by the speed of light squared. And one thing to remember while doing this is that you have to use everything in standard form, standard units. So for mass, you're going to be using kilograms, and for the speed of light, you're going to be using meters per second. So the speed of light squared is 9 into 10 to the power 16. If you do it on a calculator, so the speed of light itself is actually 300 million meters per second. So that squared is 9 into 10 to the power 16, or 9 with 16 zeros, or 90 quadrillion meters per second. That is a big number. So if I do this on the calculator, okay, so 300 million squared, as you can see, is 9 into 10 to the power 16, so 90 quadrillion. So guys, just by looking at the speed of light squared, you can actually feel how big that number is, that just in a small amount of mass, there can be such a big amount of energy. This is exactly what Einstein was trying to prove when he actually discovered this theory. He was trying to prove that in a small amount of mass, there can be an enormous amount of energy. Okay, now let me give you an example. So let's say you want to find the amount of energy in 10 kilograms of mass. So this should be like pretty easy. The answer will be 9 into 10 to the power 17, which, let's still do this. So 9 into 10 to the power 16. You can also type in 90 quadrillion, but really, you know, it's just much easier if you type in 9 into 10 to the power 16. And let's just put a bracket around this. That's something there for it to do. Times 10. Which is basically 9 into 10 to the power 17. So that is basically 900 quadrillion joules of energy. Guys, that is a lot of energy in just 10 kilograms of mass. So, yeah guys, that's about it. That is what E equals mc squared means, how you can use it in formulas. So one fun thing to do would be that if you take your mass, and you, basically your weight, and you multiply it by the speed of light squared, you can actually find the amount of energy that is inside you. So that's pretty cool, right? So, yeah, that's about it. This video was on E equals mc squared, what it means, how you can use it in calculations. And basically what we learned from this video is that even a very small amount of mass can have an enormous amount of energy. Exactly what Einstein was trying to prove. So, yeah, guys, that's about it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. If you learned something new, please, guys, hit that like button. And, guys, please subscribe to my channel for more such content. I upload videos at least once a week, so it really should be worth it. And, yeah, guys, that's about it. I'll see you in the next video, and until then, guys, peace.